Hello and welcome to our channel. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up Calibre RealTime Digital to run batch Calibre SmartFill through LSF from Synopsys Fusion Compiler. Calibre RealTime Digital enables designers to run Calibre DRC and Calibre SmartFill directly from planner tools like Siemens EDA Aprisa, Synopsys Fusion Compiler, and Cadence Innovus. Users get instant feedback directly in their planner tool. You can launch Calibre DRC through the Calibre RealTime Digital interface on a small area and get feedback in seconds. However, running full chip density or antenna checks on a very large design or adding dummy fills takes more CPU and memory resources. In these cases, it is recommended to run on a different machine, so it won't compete with planar for resources on the local machine. The Calibre RealTime interface allows you to run batch Calibre jobs on either the local host or to an LSF grid. Click the Options button in the Calibre RealTime toolbar, then choose the Batch tab to review the current settings. Check the Queue Command option field. Specify the exact command to submit batch Calibre job on your grid host. Point to your LSF job script with these three arguments. The first argument %C is for the Calibre executable path. The second argument %O captures all the Calibre command line options. The third argument, %T, is for the path to the Calibre transcript output file. We recommend setting these options in an LSF script so RealTime Digital can pass the Calibre executable, Calibre command line options, and Calibre output transcript file to your LSF job. Calibre RealTime will capture the batch Calibre job status from the transcript log. Here is an example shell script used to submit a Calibre job on LSF. In this example, it passes two environment variables, mgc_home and mgls_license_file, to run the Calibre job on a Red Hat 7.9 host. The first argument is the Calibre executable path. The second argument is the Calibre DRC or Calibre SmartFill options to run batch Calibre. The third argument is the path of the Calibre transcript file. You can redirect the standard output of this queue command to a file by adding greater than followed by ampersand before the file name. Click OK to close this options dialog. In the Calibre RealTime toolbar, click Fill as the mode. Next, click the Run button to run batch Calibre SmartFill using your LSF script on the full chip. While launching a batch Calibre job, Calibre RealTime writes out the GDS file to the temporary directory $mgc_home/temp on the host where you are running planner by default. This directory points to /var/temp on the local host. Check the error message at the end of the transcript log file. A Calibre job on remote LSF host cannot access this location. This is why the Calibre transcript prints a message about failing to open the input file under /var/temp. Let's close Fusion Compiler and fix the environment setting issue. The environment variable mgc_temptdir can force Calibre RealTime Digital to write a temporary GDS file to the specified directory at a location that any remote host may access. In this example, I set the mgc_temptdir variable to the directory where I launched planner from. Now we can restart Fusion Compiler. In the Calibre RealTime toolbar, choose Run Mode Fill again, then click the Run button to relaunch the job. You can see RealTime Digital runs Calibre SmartFill and successfully back annotates the SmartFill results in the Fusion Compiler database. That's all there is to it. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Or if you want to suggest a new video topic, please drop your suggestion in the comment section below.